And then this morning, I'm walking in a little late, there's a fire alarm going on. And so I leave to like not be in the blazing lights and bing, ding, 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 and Esther Perel is outside. And Esther Perel ultimately says, well, give me your talk. Like, let's do it right here. I'm like shitting myself. Okay, sorry, I use foul language, Philadelphia. But you don't refuse divine breadcrumbs, right? When Esther Perel says, like, I want to hear your talk, let me do this with you. You just drop all your wheelie bags and all the motherhood that you left this morning driving in from Boulder, and you're like, okay, here we go, let's do it, we're doing it. So she gave back to me what I really want to give to you, which is that when we show up and really, really are true to who we are, what I like to call being naked, amazing opportunities for growth, connection, and transformation can happen. Because honestly, like, I didn't have to talk to her, but of course I was going to. It was me, and I'm like, Esther Perel's outside, and she's so fascinating. I'm kind of having a fangirl moment, right? So I just do what I do, which is to go up to her, and out of that comes her, like, incredible generous spirit. And I walk away with, like, 20 minutes of mentorship that I never knew would happen when I arrived here. And that's what I want to talk with you about today. That your happiness and your freedom and the impact you can have on the world hinges upon your self-expression. It hinges upon you being you. It doesn't matter if you is quiet or you is loud or you don't have to talk to Esther Perel or all the other embarrassing people I talk to, according to my children. Like, you being you is where the freedom lies. So when I was 22 years old, and a really big smackdown. Anybody ever had one of those, right? Like, totally humbling experience. And I had just gotten back from, I had graduated college and I'd gone off to Africa to teach. It was like a lifelong dream. When I came back, I was super fired up and inspired to like change the world, right? And I was certain that my passion alone and my drive would actually do that. And so I got my first job. I put on my like Ann Taylor black suit. Anybody know Ann Taylor? I took the train into Center City, Philadelphia from my mom's house in the burbs, and I rocked the interview. I was freaking out. I don't know that I rocked the interview, but I got the job. And I was gonna work in four different inner city Philadelphia schools, and I was like, I got this. Like, racism, poverty, social inequity, education systems and urban settings, got it, right? And a few months in, I'm called into my boss's office, and my bosses are all older, seasoned, very wise African-American women. And they basically said, Sage, your enthusiasm and optimism is just arrogant and naive. Yeah, and that's what it felt. Like, you know, vomit in your mouth, literally almost. Like, I was like, tail between my legs, like, oh my gosh, I'm so humiliated. I cannot believe I offended these amazing women. And I wanted to do what we're trained to do as women in this culture, which is just sort of like run and hide, don't make waves, be polite, like do what they tell me to do. But like, I really still wanted to do a good job. I was still me. I was still that like idealistic, white, educated, go-getting kind of girl, right? And I needed help. I needed to figure this out. So I went to my dad, which might seem unlikely because the white male, like, okay, here we are, emerging women. That's who you're going to get your guidance from, right? But my dad had a lot of wisdom and experience of putting himself into other cultures and communities. And he was married to an African-American woman, and he was the first white member of the Black Baptist Church in West Philly with her. And he'd worked from India to South Africa. And I'm like, Dad, I'm a total asshole. Like, I'm sobbing. I can, like, and I'm like, what do I do? And so I muster my courage after talking to him and crying a lot. And I go back into them and I'm like, I'm so sorry. Like, can you teach me? Because I really want to serve. And they taught me this lesson of moving from humiliation to humility and humanity. And none of that would have been possible if I had continued to pretend that I knew it all, that I had it figured out, right? And it wouldn't have been possible either if I hadn't stayed true to that idealism, because I still was like, I'm still me and I need to be me. I can't be them, but I can be me, right? And from that, like, it really was humiliating. From that deeply humiliating experience came the opportunity for us to do really good work in the world. And when you show up like that, as your naked self revealed, You have the opportunity to grow, and you have the opportunity to connect in ways that are not possible otherwise. So if you look at the macro lens as Emerging Women's been doing it, right, like, obviously women in leadership, we need it. Duh, I don't even need to say anything, it's been said better this whole weekend, right? But also for each of you right here, right now, on this Saturday afternoon in Denver, like, I really believe, and Harvard backs this up in a longitudinal study, but the crux of our happiness is contingent upon our relationships. And the only way to have the kind of relationships you want to have is to be that naked, self-expressed person that you are, because people can't really love who they don't really know. Like, you only get half love for the half parts of you. And it's messy, and it's scary as hell, and sometimes it's humiliating. And if you know me, like, I don't always have the best filter, and I stick my foot in my mouth, right? But I get the goods, too, in the mess. So that's what I want to invite you to consider. Like, what would that be like for you? What would that be like for you if you spent less time worrying about what others think of you? It's exhausting, right? We are always self-censoring as women. I'm not saying I've got that figured out, by the way. My stomach is like freaking out right now. Okay? But from that place of freedom, what would you say or do differently in your life? And what would that self-knowing and that confidence feel like? So I'm gonna give you another example. I have the profound privilege of watching this unfold now with the women I work with and like having them reconnect with that playful, curious, free part of themselves. And I have a client, she called her Jane. And many of you may relate to this. She just like, motherhood like hijacked her identity. She's like, phew, gone. Before she really realized it, and then all of a sudden she's like, my marriage is completely falling apart. Affairs, tragedy, no friends, nobody knows what's really going on with her. Everything looks good, polished like California lifestyle, and she's fucking miserable. And she knows that she used to be that like 9-year-old girl who would be on the picnic table with her family, like camping and like belting out John Mellencamp songs, and she's like, oh my gosh, age, I used to be that. Like, what the hell happened? She's terrified to be naked again. Because like, what if people don't like her? Who am I anyway? What if the women I share myself with are like, no, like, actually, not so into it? Or what if my husband moves further away from this marriage, right? But she was unhappy enough to try it. And like, little by little, she told some women really what was going on. She asked a neighbor for help, and she spent some time exploring who she was, and she like completely transformed her marriage. Like, not, she didn't save a marriage. She, like, stepped into a new possibility of what marriage could be. And for the first time in years, she has friends. Like, she's like, I'm doing this, and blah, 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 you know? And friends who, like, aren't ignorant to what's actually going on for her. Like, she took a layer off. She had peeled off some of those layers of pretending. And what she really got clear on, and I want you to consider this for yourself, is when you lose yourself, you have a lot to lose. And way beyond you, like, the world misses out. The world misses out on who you are. And if you've been like me, and you're listening to these amazing women this weekend, and you're like, oh my gosh, what am I gonna say that they haven't said better, you know? Like, everyone's story is their own. It's all your own naked experience. So, fast forward to now, and I have a neighbor who's 15 years old, and the other day I got to spend some time with her. She took my 4-year-old and I took her 15-year-old, right? Martha and I. And Martha's sitting across from me and she's like, gosh, this woman came to our house, Sage, and she's like, Mara, you look good. And Martha's going, what the fuck? Because Martha has cancer. For the second time. And when I was 23, I also had cancer. And so with me, Martha doesn't have to pretend, right? So the woman, she said, oh, thank you. And to me, she's like, is that all anybody's ever gonna see anymore? And I'm like, no, babe. I'm like, yeah, it totally sucks, but you're still a badass mountain biking, budding engineer, bakes a mean chocolate cake, hangs out with my kids on Friday nights eating popcorn, full experience of a young woman. And when I stop pretending everything's totally okay, it gives her permission to really show up as herself and to be held in that space of non-pretending, of nakedness. And that's what you all have the power to do as women. That's what we have the power to do for each other. It's fucking exhausting to act like we've got it figured out. And it costs you an enormous amount of powerful energy. And it's a disservice to your family, your communities, and really the world. So I want to invite you to something. Like, we've been here this weekend, get all those like feel good personal development orgasms, and then like you leave and there's your life. There's your life. I want you to practice. I want to invite you to like strip tease. This is a theme, I guess, today, right? 1% naked. Just 1%. Like, share your quirky sense of humor with someone. When they ask for your honest feedback, be courageous enough to give it to them. Say yes when you freaking want to, and no when you know it's not right. Allow yourself that curiosity and just see what happens. Like, the goal here is that little by little, over time, it gets harder and harder to not be yourself. And that's where the freedom lies.